This is this week's paid promoter snippet. We gon' unite the whole city. I know we gon' do it for sure. But naysayers will say I'm impure. Remember, Jesus is the cure. Some niggas died, and I know that's for sure. When you live and you die by the sword. But if you're alive, then you still got time, so appreciate this shit more. Like what you heard, be sure to click down below in the description. And also feel free to email us at complexambition401@gmail.com.
They gon' love me for my ambition. Beautiful music, painting pictures, this be my vision.
Man, shout out to everybody out there in the world. You guys could be anywhere in the world, but you're here with us today. Complex Ambition Sound.
My name is YI.
And today, we have a very special guest.
Very special. From the bottom of my heart, it's a very special guest.
We grew up listening to his music. He's from our city. And now, man, he's the infamous signed to Lil Wayne motherfucking Euro, everybody.
Woo! Thank you for being here, bro. It's an absolute blessing. I don't think you understand how happy we are to have you in this car. We're right in front of the fucking school you went to. This is coincidentally where we record.
Jorge Alvarez. Shout out to everybody who went to Alvarez.
It used to be called Adelaide.
Adelaide. That's crazy, bro. Man, it's history. There's a lot of history in the city, man. How long has it been since, like, you fully, like, lived out here? And, like, how long has it been since, like, everything kind of, like, you know, made that big move?
2013. That's 2013? Everything kicked off. I, you know, as they say, jumped off the porch.
6 years.
Yeah, we started doing the touring. I met Wayne. He took me out there overseas. Came back. We did a tour.
Wow.
And I've just been away from home ever since.
Wow, that's crazy. And were you like a huge fan of him yourself, as like everybody, especially in 2013, and that whole like pre-decade era was? Because me, in my opinion, I always say, like, he's my favorite rapper of all time. I think he's the best rapper of all time, especially, like, the skill-wise. But were you that much of, like, a, you know, that type of, like, damn, this is Wayne, when you met him and he saw you?
Yeah. I was a big fan.
Yeah.
Him and Jay-Z.
Oh, hell yeah. No, that's...
Yeah. And Drizzy at that time.
Yeah.
I was a big fan of those guys. So that whole camp, the whole Young Money vibe that they had going on, at that time, I was a huge fan of it. Everything they was doing, how they was moving.
Yeah.
You know, Drizzy, you know.
That's lovely.
That must have been mad surreal.
Yeah, I ain't.
Fuck out of here with that shit.
Yeah.
It's like looking at a ghost when you see
it. Yeah, I was at this school the first time I heard Drizzy, you know.
That's
whole
crazy.
Young Money wave. But
Best I've ever had.
I was a real huge fan of that. I've been a fan of Wayne since, like, middle school, 06. Mixtapes and all that.
Jesus Christ. And how does that feel not to collaborate with him? One thing is just being one of his artists, but how does it feel collaborating with this man?
Oh, man, it's crazy, man.
Because you guys have historic collaborations, bro.
Oh, man, my appreciate God. It.
That's
no,
love.
I'm being real, man.
No,
100%. It's fantastic.
That's love.
It's love. The thing is, you could sign to someone, but, like, they're not going to be that willy-nilly to, like, just show you love as 100%. Far as, like, a feature.
100%.
Right. Like, this is my artist.
Yeah, yeah.
But, like, he does that shit so, like, like, he trusts in your fucking skill ability, and he's probably, obviously, does he say himself, like, he's a fan of you?
Yeah, well, not really. He don't say that.
He's a harsh love? Yeah, competitive.
He's tough, but he lets me know.
Like, you know when he, like, recognizes what you're doing.
He lets me know.
And didn't you recently come out to URI to perform?
Oh, yes.
Oh, yeah, I did.
You opened up at our school. Yeah, that's true,
yeah,
for him.
When Wayne came out there, I was out there. We performed. Yeah,
that's fire.
One of the best fun performances we had.
What are we here to do today?
Talk to me crazy, man.
Yes, sir.
This is off of, what's the name of this project right
Don't
now?
Don't expect nothing.
Don't
man.
Expect
yeah, this
nothing.
Is my debut project, my very first project.
That's
you know?
Amazing. And we yeah. ourselves, we were like, yo, we always said it, for, especially since we started doing these reactions, we're like, yo, when is Euro dropping, yo? When is he dropping? It's been a minute, bro. How long has it been since, like, because you never, did you ever have, like, you obviously had tapes. What was, like, the last tape, like, before this? It was,
I dropped 7 songs.
Yeah, the little EP.
Called The July.
Mm-hmm. I remember that, yes.
Yeah, that's the only thing I dropped other than this. But I was, on the features, playing around.
Yeah.
Jumping on tracks with Wayne and his projects. And
all the dedication tapes and everything. You don't see it too much. It's almost like artist development in a sense. Do you feel like it's like artist development that's going on with you?
Yeah, I feel like naturally I'm going to develop, just naturally, you know what I'm saying? But
it's
more so being patient.
Yeah.
It's more so being patient than trying to develop. I'm blessed enough where I don't rely on rap to live or survive.
Yeah,
like
That's
like,
beautiful. That's beautiful.
Good for you, nigga.
Yeah,
yeah.
So people, you know, you have a different sense of
urgency.
Being able, yeah, so you don't just jump in the first situation you see, or absolutely. You don't get rushed by the internet, absolutely. Or when people be attacking you, you know, that doesn't really bother you, because, you know, I love rap, and, you 100%. Know, rap is my passion.
But you don't got all your coins in one, all your eggs in one basket.
Yeah, but we ain't out here just, you know, surviving off one avenue. So.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So that's what that helps a lot.
That's a fact, nigga. Not for nothing. No homo. You could be an actor, nigga. You got the, I can see you doing some roles and shit, nigga. I don't know. You know what I'm saying? You might be typecasting at first. They always typecast motherfuckers of color. They always gotta make us be the robber and shit.
I gotta start up with some
type. Something gonna happen, nigga. Issa Rae, one of them niggas out there, HBO, let's get it popping. You know what I'm saying?
Lena Waithe.
Lena Waithe, she's out here.
She's out here.
We definitely wanna do some acting, some movies.
Okay. Hey, we might have to put you in some talk skits or some shit. Yeah. We'll do something. 2020.
It's what I study, nigga. Let's do it.
Talk to me crazy. We're going to get into it right now. If you guys are watching it with us the first time, it's going to be a hell of a ride. But if you're watching it again, rewatch this motherfucker 100 times. Talk to me crazy. The music video with Euro himself.
Let's get it.
Shit. We talked that acting shit into existence. He's already doing a little skit in the beginning.
Oye, no me hable así. Don't talk to me crazy. Yeah, see that in the morning. Yeah, I'm going crazy. No one can fade me. Look what it made me. Coming from basement. Look at their faces. Life is amazing. Look at us changing. Imagine us caged in. Imagine us anywhere other than this. I don't wanna talk about people I miss. Same time I shoot it,
straight
to hit.
Come and fight, start dying.
This nigga got the heart flow, got the heart flow.
I'm from somewhere far away. Keep the police far away. I need woman now.
She got a little body on her.
Jigga Marty Day. Even after we just skate, don't talk to me crazy.
Alright, I'm on my way. Oh shit.
This is a little situation. It's a little movie.
Don't talk to me crazy. Be there in the morning. I'm having a ball. No one can fade me. Look what it made me.
Oh,
don't talk to me crazy. That's chocolate on the pavement. My daughter is dating. Please, my nigga, don't talk to her crazy. I'm south, so I'm crazy. And I don't need a face. And steal my cages. And you saw that you hate it. She from Saudi Arabia. And a homie from Asia. Oh my God, Dr. Evil. Dr. Strange. And Dr. Jekyll and Mr. Hyde. They call me a patient. Woo! Damn, I'm horny and wasted. Damn, I'm spawning cages. Damn, don't talk to the agents. I ball like the patrons. I sing you to hell, and you should tell Satan that I'm a real Satan.
Nigga, what the fuck is this nigga wearing? This nigga swagger.
I'm drawing out the wave, but the weapons are drawn like I do waste. I'm
rapping. My mama do paper.
But you don't want no smoke. You talk to me crazy, I'ma go crazy. Don't talk to me crazy. Be there in the morning. I'm going crazy. No one can fade me. Look what it made me. Look what it made me. Look what it made me.
That's crazy, dog.
Niggas killed it with those little ads.
Yo, that was fire.
Jesus Christ, man.
That was fire. Talk to me crazy. Yo, that's crazy. Who directed that shit?
It was directed by somebody from here.
From here?
Yeah, he's like family to me. Sway Mendez.
Sway Mendez? Okay.
Yeah, what's his Instagram?
He's an OG from out here. At Sway Mendez.
At Sway Mendez, okay.
I love the plot. I love videos driven by plot.
Appreciate it, man. Mm-hmm.
No, real talk. You know what I'm saying?
No basic shit.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Y'all niggas had dedication to that. Whose idea was to like who makes that decision? Like, all right, we're going to make a music video to this song, and it's going to be like this. Who does that in your team?
So, we usually collaborate, but for this specific project, we let Sway do his thing.
Mm-hmm. Oh, okay.
Me and Sway Mendez just came up. We sent him a song. He came up with the whole treatment.
Yeah.
The idea.
Yeah.
Come from one spot. Shout out to 11. We got to shoot out of this club in Miami.
Who produced this record again?
This is produced by my homie from overseas named Ozora Miyagi.
Oh, shit.
Yeah, you did.
Any nigga with Miyagi in that shit, you know, that nigga cooking. Yeah. That nigga cooking Miyagi.
Yeah.
No respect, nothing. Man, that's I love the title. I love everything about this, to be honest.
Appreciate it,
man. Appreciate it. I think it has a good, like, touch, a good feel. Cause this shit is different. Like, I don't know. It's like, it's not like what these niggas have out right now.
Yeah, no, absolutely. I think one thing about you is always stay true to your aesthetic and your style.
It's like classic rap. Like, yeah. You know what I'm saying? Like,
It sounds like something you like when you grew up.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I'm saying? Yeah. Does that make any sense?
Yeah, 100%. Right now, you see the huge hip hop scene, the music scene.
Yeah, yeah.
There's so much different subgenres in hip hop right now.
100%.
Yeah. I try to find a way, you know, cause I grew up on Jay-Z, the Waynes, the throwback. But I also grew have you know a lot of influence from the new guys too.
Yeah, yeah,
you know,
absolutely.
And then so forth. But the whole thing is just growing.
Yeah,
growing. I'm not opposed to any of the music. If it's good music, it's good music.
You ever see yourself like maybe like fuck around and singing or some shit yourself, like trying to like vocalize?
Play
with the melodies.
So. You know, being the way I came up, that's, you know, back in the, when I was listening to Jay-Z and all that.
Yeah.
And 50, and, you know, 50 attacked Ja Rule for that.
It was like looked down upon and shit.
You know, it wasn't, but, you know, I feel like if you have a voice, you can do it. And me, I actually do have a lot of songs where I'm
more
so. Yeah, we're going to bring that out the next more, so.
I had that Euro R&B tape.
Oh, yeah.
Euro R&B.
I'm really the king of R&B.
Imagine, okay. Imagine that
nigga
go viral.
This nigga sounds confident, though, nigga. I think this nigga's not fucking around.
He has a confident energy.
Yeah, we gonna get to that. Right now, I'm just dealing with... rap.
He's just playing right now.
And
he's
so what's right
practice.
Now? Is it gonna be a tour right now? What's going on, bro?
Yeah, we're gonna set up some shows. We're gonna get out there.
Yeah.
Hit the stage.
Yeah.
But we plotting that out now, you know.
Absolutely.
Fourth quarter is tricky. We got holidays.
Yeah.
I really just wanted to release it this year.
Okay.
I wasn't thinking of this, but subconsciously, kind of, you know, Jay-Z dropped Reasonable Doubt, and he was 26.
Yeah.
So I kind of want to drop my, you know...
Something while you're 26.
While I'm 26. So
that's a fact.
I just build on that.
Yeah, yeah. But it's really symbolic, and it goes to show you, I mean, at the end of the day, niggas don't got to be, like, number one in the world, or number one in the charts, because at the end of the day, if you think about it, even Reasonable Doubt, when that shit dropped, it was not popping like that, you know, and he was 26, I forgot that nigga was that, like,
absolutely.
Not even young, but, like, old,
yeah.
That's old, it's like, because nowadays, music motherfuckers come out, 18, Trippie Redd, all these niggas, 18, 16, they popping, but it's like, nah, this is more like the organic, classic way that shit really happens, you know what I'm saying?
Absolutely.
So you really have a long career ahead of you.
No, man. Absolutely, bro. We're really proud of you,
man.
Thank you for doing what you do. Sometimes I think people forget that artists provide service.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
Oh, yeah. 100%.
You're providing a service, man. You're inspiring people, whether it is with your lyrics or whether it's, you know, directly to, like, rap just like you. You're inspiring them in
some
sort of capacity.
Or even just your status and just getting to where you've gotten to.
Yeah.
Coming from where we're from.
Yeah.
You know, something that's not easy, bro. Like, I swear to God, like...
Because people got... You got to realize, like, these people who you basically, you know, you rub shoulders with all the time. Wayne and Drake's and all these people, you know, if you're around these circles, that in itself should be respected. Because they're not going to just let no clown or corny motherfucker around them. They know the energy that they're going to provide, you know, within their camp and shit.
Right.
So you being around that speaks volumes.
And it shows the kids that they can do it too.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? So I appreciate this shit,
man. Appreciate that, man.
We're going to get that interview
going.
That's love, man.
Thank you so
much,
man.
Euro, baby. Euro to Providence. More videos coming soon with him. Let's stay in touch. Everybody out there, show love to him. Go get that motherfucking project out right now. Don't expect nothing. And watch his motherfucking video 100 times, please. Why not? Comment submission, baby. Sound.
My name is YI.
It's Euro. Love. Providence. We out.
Underdogs understand what I lay over tracks. New school, but all I listen to is older raps. Bitch, I still been drinking on the low. I never think because I know.